You've seen a ghost. Come on, 9-year-olds are not that scary. What happened? My flashlight went out, and there was something in the dark. A monster, just like Davy had drawn. Davy tends to run away with pieces of evidence, and your imagination tends to run away with you. Nobody's perfect. This is a small basement. I'd notice a 7-foot glue goblin if there was one. Maybe it's not entirely physical, a mental manifestation of sorts. I've read about similar phenomena, stigmata, demonic possession. And I've read about FBI agents reading extensively on stigmata and all that crap. There's one thing they all seem to share. Well, two things. They're all either mental or dead. I'm serious. A strong emotion can be manifested physically. And what could be stronger than the suffering of an abused child? A murderer's desire to get away with the murder, for one. Let's go talk to Mark. He's been lying to us. Are you done already? You're getting in the way and scaring Davy. We know you've lied to us, Mr. Cooper. What do you mean? No one broke into your house. You staged the break-in after you'd killed your wife. Why would I do that? After the divorce, Karen would have got it all, the house, the money, even Davy. I couldn't take it anymore. She was going to get full custody. I had no choice. I've seen wives getting full custody and keeping their brains inside their skulls. There's always a choice. When I got home, Davy was bleeding. She hit him, again. I took a hammer, one blow was enough to stop it for good. When I realized what I'd done, I panicked. That's when I smashed the door and called the police. A confession is nice, but a confession and a murder weapon gets you a cell with a view. Where's the hammer? I think I'll call my lawyer now. I've said enough as it is. No view then. Search the house, rookie, while I cuff him and do the paperwork. He had little time to hide the murder weapon. It has to be somewhere here. This screwdriver is out of place. The other tools are neatly organized. There's something behind the vent. Gotcha. Has to be the murder weapon. Davy's clothes. They're drenched in blood. Why? He was supposed to be in his room during the murder. So, this is the hammer. But what the hell are Davy's clothes doing here? Mark Cooper seems to have been lying about a wide range of things, not just his alibi. Cooper's fingerprints are on it. Wait, the hammer must have come from that toolbox over there. Of course his prints are all over it. Agent Dale will laugh me out of the bureau if I register this as evidence. Wait, there's a second set of prints on the hammer. Small ones. Must be Davy's. Blood, brain matter, bone fragments. This kid really doesn't know how to keep his clothes clean. Wait, this means Davy was inches away from Karen when her skull cracked. Mark must have hidden his clothes before calling the cops. Damn. Hi, Davy, can we talk? You can't take away my dad. He didn't hurt anyone. I told you, it was the monster. Maybe sometimes, Mr. Howard's dog, the monster set it on fire. Why would a monster do such a monstrous thing? I was upset. Bad things happen when I'm upset. Mom says it's my fault. It's because I'm not normal. And then she gets angry. Davy, you saw what happened to your mom, didn't you? Yeah. Can you tell me? I got syrup on my shirt. She was really angry. She hit me. Only this time I got really angry too. I followed her to the basement. And then the monster came. I tried to stop him, I tried so hard. He hit her with his war hammer, and she fell. That's when my dad got home. He chased the monster away. He always does. He told me to change my clothes. And then I saw him hiding the hammer. A husband comes home, and his wife is in the basement with a monster. Sounds like a bad joke. Sadly, it's not. Davy, I need to talk to your dad again, before Agent Dale takes him away. Oh hi, Mr. Cooper. Care to stop lying for a moment now? What? Why would I lie? You know why, and if you want to see your son ever again, you need to tell me the truth now. How many times did you hit your wife, Mr. Cooper? I hit her once. Where did you hit her? I hit her in the head. You think you're a smart bastard, don't you? You caught me anyway, so I must be not as smart as you think I think I am. You didn't do it. Karen was killed with two blows, not one. First, the killer shattered her femur. Then he smashed her skull. You don't know these details. You probably weren't even there. Davy must have found the divorce papers. He knew Karen was going to get full custody, and you won't be there to protect him. So. He's a troubled boy, isn't he? With a mom like that, who wouldn't be? So, he took your hammer. No. He hit her in the thigh. The autopsy showed both blows were made from below, with terrible strength. His rage must have given him the power. When she fell, he hit her again. This time he broke her skull. That's when you came home. You panicked. You tried to stage a robbery. But in the end, we didn't buy it. So you had to protect your son at any cost, even if it meant going to jail for him. You don't know how it was for Davy. She beat him, he was just protecting himself. You can't arrest him. Karen was a DA. No one will show mercy, not even to a kid. His life will be over. Don't tell your partner. Let them arrest me. A jealous loser kills his successful wife for money. The jury will eat it up. Who would believe that the pillar of justice was beating her kid at home? I have no proof. It died with Karen. I beg you, Agent. Davy is just a kid. He has his whole life ahead of him. Don't rob him of that. Davy, we've got big plans for you. Try looking less like shit, rookie. Go get a drink. You've put a killer behind bars. It is strange, though, how Davy managed the whole thing. Not every adult could have shattered Karen's bones like that, even with a hammer. Having a monster for a mom must have taught him to be one, in the end. Well. You've said it yourself, things don't add up here. And I saw something in that basement, Dale. I saw it. Keep it up, rookie, and you'll get a full checkup at a mental institution instead of the next case. They'll never do that. Not to an agent who's just solved a murder case. You think so? Ever heard of a bloke called Fox Mulder? Thank you. grabbed him. He killed the president. Don't shoot. I'm a federal agent.
Não pretendemos assim, gente.